experience. And in case I haven't embarrassed her enough, she's got a wonderful family. I watched her kids grow up, and today is her birthday. So happy birthday, Penny. So for your birthday present, you get to go through confirmation. It's going to be great. Meanwhile, over two decades in both the public and private sectors, Mike Froman, who I'm nominating to serve as my U.S. trade representative, has established himself as one of the world's foremost experts on our global economy. And I'm not surprised, by the way, because we went to law school together. He was much smarter than me then. He continues to be smarter than me now. And over the past 4 years, he's been my point person at global forums like the G8 and the G20. And by the way, when I say point person, he's really been the driving force oftentimes in organizing these incredible international summits in which huge amounts of business get done. He's been a key negotiator alongside Ron Kirk on those trade agreements for South Korea, Colombia, and Panama, which support tens of thousands of American jobs. He's won the respect of our trading partners around the world. He's also won a reputation as being an extraordinarily tough negotiator. While doing it, he does not rest until he's delivered the best possible deal for American businesses and American workers. He's fought to make sure that countries that break the rules are held accountable. And Mike believes, just as I believe, and just as Penny believes, that our workers are the most competitive in the world. So they deserve a level playing field. And Mike's going to continue to fight for that level playing field in his new role as he helps to move forward trade negotiations with both the Asia-Pacific region and Europe, and will also continue to advise me on a broad range of economic issues. And as I think some of you have gathered, I've had a chance to get to know Penny and Mike, not just as leaders and professionals, but also as friends. One of the reasons I'm proud to nominate them is they don't forget what matters. They know this is not about just growing balance sheets. It's about growing opportunity for people. It's about growing a sense of security for the middle class. And most of all, they operate with integrity. And they understand that public service is a privilege, and you've got to do it right when you get involved on behalf of the American people. So I just want to thank Penny and Mike and their extraordinary families for agreeing to serve in these roles. I urge the Senate to confirm Penny and Mike without delay, because they've got a lot of work to do, and I intend to work them to the bone as soon as they're official. So thank you very much, everybody, and thanks to their families for putting up with what I know will be challenging, but ultimately the extraordinary reward of working on behalf of the American people. Thank you very much.
Thank you, right. Thank you, Mr. President. You got it.
I can read it.